you're asked to make a decision on the spot about a lens that's going to go inside your eye for all of eternity. Which one do you choose? Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist and cataract surgeon. The most important decision you're going to have to make after you decide to have cataract surgery is which lens you want inside your eye for the rest of your lifetime. And this is not a straightforward answer. There's no one size fits all. And the decision can be daunting. There are so many different lenses and types of lenses. So today I thought we'd take some time to go over the current lens offerings, the pros and cons of each, as well as who should consider or who would benefit from certain types of lenses. Let's get started. In the United States, when insurance covers a cataract surgery, they're going to include the cost of a standard lens. A standard lens is a lens that is a very simple lens. It is the same power throughout. If you have astigmatism, which is when your cornea is shaped more like a football than a baseball, you will most likely need to wear glasses for perfect vision after surgery. Also, even if you don't have astigmatism and you get the standard lens and you set it for distance vision, you will still need to wear glasses for reading. If you're okay with the idea of wearing glasses after surgery, you can click off now because you should get the standard lens that's covered by insurance. Now, for those of you who want the option of being glasses free for some or all things, let's talk about some of those options and how you can achieve spectacle independence. There are a couple ways you can achieve this. One option would be to do something called monovision. This is when we set your dominant eye for distance and your non-dominant eye for computer or reading. This can work well for some people. In fact, anyone who has worn contact lenses with monovision or who has had LASIK or PRK or RK surgery with monovision would be a fantastic candidate for monovision. If you don't have that much astigmatism, then you can just do monovision with the standard lens covered by insurance, which would be covered by the cost of the surgery. If you do have astigmatism, you may need to correct the astigmatism using a lens called a toric lens. And this is a lens that goes into your eye that can actually offset some of the astigmatism that's caused by your cornea. Another cool option to consider if you are considering monovision but have never tried it before would be to consider a light adjustable lens. This is a lens that you can put inside your eye and adjust the power after the surgery. And what's cool about this is if you've never done monovision before, you can set both eyes to distance initially and kind of play around with the focal point of your non-dominant eye. You get a few treatments with the light adjustable lens, and in between treatments, you have an opportunity to experience how you're doing in the world with your focal point. And this can be fine-tuned and adjusted to your needs after cataract surgery. If monovision isn't for you, another option would be a lens called a multifocal lens. The most common type of multifocal lens is a trifocal lens, which has three focal points: distance, computer, and reading. This lens can be a great option for those who cannot do monovision and who want to be completely glasses free. The downside being that you will have some glare at nighttime. Most of the time, it's not as bad as the glare you have with your cataracts, but it can be visually debilitating. Especially if you're someone who does a lot of nighttime driving, this can be a consideration. In order to have a good outcome from a multifocal lens, you actually need to have a near perfect eye, meaning there's no macular degeneration, no scar tissue on your retina, and no corneal pathology. So if you're not a candidate for a multifocal lens, or if you are bothered by the idea of nighttime glare, an in-between option would be an extended depth of focus lens, or an EDOF lens. This is a lens that actually provides a blended range of vision. You do not get nighttime glare as badly as you would with a multifocal lens. You won't get as much range, about anywhere from 1 to 1.5 diopters, but that could be enough to get you from distance to maybe your iPad. Sometimes what we'll do with this extended depth of focus lens is either mix and match different lenses or do a little bit of monovision with this, where we do one eye for distance to computer and one eye for computer to reading. You can check out my video on multifocal lenses versus EDOF lenses for more information about these two lenses. I hope this was helpful. I really wanted to make this video so I can talk about some of the updated lenses like the light adjustable lens. I did make a video all about the light adjustable lens that you can check out if you're interested. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.